because BTS asked for
A boycott,
a
obviously.
boycott of Eurovision.
Or rather, like, put a lot of pressure on the national broadcaster here to just skip the
To not
competition this
air it?
year.
Yeah, there were
Yes.
30,000 signatures.
Which is a big portion of the population.
I think it's great that you guys are using this platform to make some sort of statement.
Thank you.
Do you have any ideas yet?
Politics isn't something confined to parliamentarians or ministers. Politics is for everyday people, it's for artists, it's for people doing all sorts of jobs, people making documentaries and movies. People are allowed to have their political opinions. And when we come to artists, I think they have a really special freedom to use all sorts of strategies to mediate those opinions.
We have to remember, like, you know, both Israel and Eurovision artists are here because of the Second World War. So we're basically dealing with the Second World War here and its consequences. Eurovision as dancing on Palestinian graves. If you really want to be apolitical, which sounds really ironic, it's as political as it gets. But regardless, if you want to be apolitical, don't hold Eurovision in a state that is guilty of apartheid, occupation, and ethnic cleansing.
So that's a political statement in
That's
itself.
A very political statement in itself.
We address our statement to Benjamin Netanyahu, Prime Minister of Israel and Chairman of the Likud National Liberal Movement.
We members of Hatari hereby challenge you to a friendly match of traditional Icelandic trouser grip wrestling, or glima.
חושב, אנחנו הגענו למתיאס הרלסון, חבר הלהקה, והוא בשיחה ראשונה עם התקשורת הישראלית, מספר על ההתמודדות של הלהקה עם הלחץ הציבורי והתקשורתי שמופעל עליה להחרים את האירוויזיון פה בארץ.
Like Iceland is one of the two countries in Western Europe who recognize Palestine as a state. There's a lot of pressure here in Iceland to boycott this competition. But we thought maybe we can take part and criticize the Israeli government with discussion, with art, with ideas, rather than boycotting.
We are told that 200 million people could watch Eurovision, and I do want people's minds to take them outside of the Eurovision bubble just for a minute and think about the context.